Hi there guys, Rick Graham back again for another review for Guitar Interactive magazine. I'm very privileged to have this particular amplifier for review today. It's an Orange Micro Terra head, and as you can see, it's pretty small, but having played it for the first time, it's, to be honest, just phenomenal. The sound is incredible. So I think the first thing I need to do is just talk you through its functions, and there aren't many. So it shan't take too long to do, and then we'll get to some playing examples. So as you can see, it's very, very small, but it's very, very well made. It has a metal chassis, which is extremely important for something that small. And if we look at the controls, starting from left to right, we have a power switch, on-off switch, a phones jack. We have an auxiliary in just in case you want to plug an iPod or something else into it. And then we have simply volume, tone and gain controls, as well as your guitar input. On the actual rear of the head itself, we have the power input, and also we have a speaker input, which is 4 ohm or more, so you can have some fun connecting this up with various different cabs. So why don't we just get to it and just do some playing with it and see what this little fella is capable of. At the moment I've got the gain on full, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep it on full, but I'm going to control everything via the guitar volume, and then we'll try some clean sounds. I know the majority of you out there really want to hear how it sounds full tilt. So we will get to that. Okay. So if I just start with the bridge pickup, and I've got the volume about halfway up. Turn the volume up just a touch more. Let's try the neck pickup. And then all the way up back to the bridge. That sounds pretty meaty, I have to say. It's incredible. I certainly wasn't expecting that when I saw it for the first time. Very, very impressive indeed. What I'm going to do now is just roll the gain off a little bit and see what kind of clean tones we can get going. So that was on full whack there, so I'm just going to roll it back. Let's take it to about 11 o'clock and bring the volume up. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing. This time I'm going to pop it onto the neck pickup. Okay, what I'm going to do now is just play some open strings and sweep this tone control so that you can hear the difference it makes. So if I roll it all the way off. So clearly you can hear there, there's a lot of variety there, and you can obviously experiment with that to try and get the tone to your taste. So that's pretty impressive. So pretty much to sum up, I think this is an amazing amplifier. For the price, it's phenomenal. It represents extremely good value for money. So if you're looking for an entry level amp, I really can't think of anything that's gonna fit the bill better than this little fella. So I urge you to get out there and try one today. All right, thanks a lot for watching this review, and I will see you guys again for the next one. Take care.
Hey, I'm Slash, and you're watching iGuitar.
Hello, and welcome to iGuitar issue 11. Slash is one of the world's most popular and recognizable guitar players, and we're delighted to welcome him to iGuitar. Speaking with Jamie Humphreys, Slash gave us the lowdown on his gear, his playing, and his new album. And if getting that Slash sound is your dream, Jamie delivers a knockout Slash style analysis and sound tutorial as well. Godsmack's Tony Rombola is our second guitar star. Godsmack holds the rare distinction of having made three consecutive number one albums and remain one of the USA's top grossing bands. And if live guitar is your thing, check out Rodney Branigan, the acoustic guitarist who sets stages alight with his dynamic style, which includes playing two acoustic guitars at the same time. Rodney talks technique with Giorgio Cerchi and delivers a stunning live performance. Our fantastic competition prize this issue gives you the chance to win the Matrix GT1000 FX guitar power amp, which so impressed our review team in iGuitar 10. And also in this issue, we have part two of Paul Brett's series on affordable, collectible vintage guitars, this time featuring the US Magnetone brand. Don't forget our unique reviews headed by Marshall's awesome Slash Head, a set of Seymour Duncan Slash pickups, and IK Multimedia's Amplitude Slash system for the iPhone and iPad. And if you really want that Slash sound but you can't afford to spend thousands, we have a very affordable answer that you really must not miss from Vintage Guitars. You can also check out our reviews of gear from Ibanez, Charvel, DBZ, Orange, Source Audio, and the boutique Dr. No pedal range. For bassists, amps from Laney and... Well, for acoustic guitarists, we've got new models from Washburn and Crafter. Add our exclusive tuition columns with downloadable tab, and that's iGuitar, the first interactive magazine for guitarists the world over. And still, completely free.